Timers in iOS are notoriously hard to set up, but not in Swift UI, because that is just one single line of code, and of course an onRecEIVE. So if you do want to learn about this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, because today we are going to build out this interface. We are going to count down till New Year's Eve. So if you are interested in that, go ahead and hit also the like button, and let's dive in. New Year's Eve is around the corner, so let's learn how to set up a countdown timer to New Year's Eve. And along the way, you are going to learn about timers, onRecEIVE, view modifiers, and of course, all of this in Swift UI. Before we dive into the tutorial, let me remind you about DevFactory. It is at rebeloper.com/mentoring, where I can meet you with a one-on-one Zoom call, where you can just ask me any questions about Swift, Swift UI, iOS development, or if you do have a bug in your code, I would be happy to help, or you could just learn with me Swift UI. Okay, so it is at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So let me just show you what we are going to build out today. So actually, it's this one. So as you can see, it's a countdown timer till New Year's Eve. We have 34 days, 11 hours, 38 minutes and 56 seconds till New Year's Eve. And this is a really good opportunity to learn about timers and the onRecEIVE view modifier. So let's see, I have already prepared a simple, like vanilla Xcode project here, and you can take a look at the resources down below, so you can just drag and drop them. So it's a link where you can sign up for all of my YouTube tutorial resources, and this is what you will find. A photo, two files, a content view, and an int plus, and a photo credit. So let's just start off by adding our photo right over here. Let's just drag and drop it. And then let's delete our content view. Let's move to trash. And then let us just move both of them right over here. Okay. And on the content view, I have set up some stuff. So let me just build and run. Till then, here's the extension for our int. You can have 2 seconds, 2 minutes, 2 hours, to string. Yeah, you will see that in just a second. Okay, so this is how it looks like. It's just the image with 2022, and then 0 is set for the counter. And let's take a look at our content view, how it looks like. Basically, this is where we are going to work. So let me just make that a little bit larger so we can see. And this is basically it, a VStack with all of these text and spacers and the background for the image. And that's it. So what we want to do here, as you can see, currently we have a text of 0 string as the countdown timer. First of all, we want to have a state variable which actually stores the state of the time remaining, because we are going to count down from the time remaining. Okay, so that's a private state variable, a state, private var. And let me just name this maybe time remaining. There we go. And let's set the default value to 0. Now it's time to set up our timer. And setting up a timer in SwiftUI couldn't be easier. So let's just call this timer. So let timer equals. And we are going to go timer dot. And we are going to publish. And let's just use this every tolerance on in options. We're not going to use all of them, but let's just go with this initializer. On every, that's a time interval. So let's just use one for every 1 second. So the timer will tick once a second. We don't care about the tolerance. Now, this is important on the run loop. We want to have that dot main. Because this is going to update our UI. So we want to have that on the main thread. And then run loop mode, let's just use our common, that's our usual one, and we don't care about the options for now. Now, this is our timer. Also, when this view loads, we want to start the timer, and that is really simple. We just go auto connect. And that's it, we have our timer. So let's just connect this to our time remaining. So how do we actually get these values from our timer? This is actually a publisher. So if you take a look at it, let's just go right over here. This is actually a publisher. So we can listen to that publisher with the onRecEIVE view modifier. And right over here after background, let's just add dot onRecEIVE and we just go timer. And we are going to get back here. Let's just select this. Oh, it's not auto-completing. Oh, that's because I added a comma instead of dot. So onRecEIVE again, timer. And then here on the output, we are going to get the actual time. First of all, we want to check if our time remaining is greater than zero. Otherwise, we don't want to subtract one from that. So let's just go if self.time remaining is greater than zero, then go self.time remaining minus equals one. So this will actually get one out of the time remaining on each second. So that's great. But currently our time remaining is zero. So yeah, it will not trigger. So what we want to do is calculate actually the seconds that we have till New Year's Eve and then add those seconds to the time remaining private state variable. We are going to do that when this view appears. So let's just go on appear right over here. And first of all, we want to know when New Year's Eve is coming. And that will be an optional. So let's just start off by having a guard let statement here, New Year and equals. And we are going to use the calendar for this purpose. So calendar.current.date component, date, let's just use the one with date from. Yes, date from. And here, as you can see, we need a date component. And that will be a date component with a set year, and that is 2022. And this couldn't be easier. So date components, and let's just have this initializer, and I will again have this long initializer. All we care about is the year, so let's just add 2022 right over there, and then let's remove all of these because as you can see they are all optionals. So let's just have that as is. Okay, so if we do have our new year date, else we just want to return. So if we do have that New Year's, then we want to set the date components from the current date till our New Year. So this is how it goes. So time remaining, I'm already setting the time remaining up because we are going to use that date seconds value. Let me just type it out. It's relatively simple. So first of all, calendar again, current date components, this one. And as you can see, we are requiring a components set. So let's just have this as a dot second, and then from our date, if you just initialize it, that is now actually. And we still need here two, yes. So yeah, that wasn't the correct initializer from autocomplete, but this is what we want, new year. And then after this, we can access its second value. And this is also an optional. Otherwise, let's just use zero. So let's set the time remaining to zero. And now everything error should go away, and it does. And basically, with the logic, we are all set up. Now it's just time to add the time remaining right over here. So let's just add it like so, time remaining. Okay, so let's hit Command R. So we can see that everything went okay And it does. As you can see, now we are displaying all of the seconds and it's counting down. But this is actually not what we want. This is where the handy extension for the end comes in. So let's just take a look at it. So here we have 2 seconds, 2 minutes, 2 hours, 2 days, and 2 strings. Let's just go through them one by one because this is really interesting to see. So right over here, for the time remaining, those int value, int extensions will return a string. So I can just delete this and go with time remaining, select the int, and then 2 seconds. And this will convert the int value to an actual string. As you can see, this is the amount of seconds that we have till New Year's Eve. Also, we can have 2 minutes. So we are converting the int value to minutes. Those are the minutes. Now you see it's not counting down because the timer is triggered every second. Of course, once the seconds do go down and it will be 49,649 or 48 rather minutes, then it will change. Okay, the same goes for hours. So 2 hours, let's just see that also. And finally, we have 2 strings. This is the hours remain till midnight, not midnight, midnight New Year's Eve. And then we can just go to also 2 days. Let's just take a look at how many days we still have left. 39 days. Okay. And finally, we can just go to string. And this is kind of what we actually want here. As you can see, we still have 34 days, 11 hours, 28 minutes, and 37 seconds. And now you can calculate, if you are smart enough, when this video was recorded. Okay, so yeah, this is how you can create an actual countdown timer in Swift UI. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call, 16 minutes of debugging your code, or maybe you want to learn Swift UI, or if you just want to talk about iOS development, I am there at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Go ahead and book your call now. Setting up timers with the help of ONRECEIVE modifier couldn't be easier. Now, if you do like this video, go ahead and smash that like button. And while you are at it, make sure to hit the notification bell to get notified of new videos. New videos like these ones. Go ahead and check them out. They are all about Swift and Swift UI. And while you're at it, make sure to check out my channel right over there. I dare you. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.